To make right decisions, pray in the Spirit. 1 Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 12. Now we have received not the spirit of this world, but the Spirit who is from God, that we might know the things that have been freely given to us by God. One of the work of the indwelling presence of the Holy Spirit is to help us know the things that have been freely given to us by God. As Paul stated here in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, he says, things which eyes haven't seen, which ears haven't heard, which man has never even thought of, such things God has prepared for those who love him. And then he says, but God reveals them to us by his Spirit. And he continues on to verse 12, which we just read, that we have received the Spirit of God so that we might know the things that are freely given to us by God. Meaning that the Spirit of God reveals this. He gives us the knowledge of what God has prepared for us and given to us. So when you and I need to make decisions, it is so important for us to tune in and listen to the Holy Spirit. Like we said, we begin by praying to God, asking Him for wisdom and guidance. We learn to apply the Word of God. We make use of a renewed mind, and we tune in to listen to the inner witness of the Holy Spirit. And another important thing that we can do is to pray in tongues, to pray in heavenly languages, to pray in the Spirit. Because the Bible says that when we pray in the Spirit, we are speaking mysteries. And what are these mysteries? These are mysteries are things that God reveals to us for our benefit. You know, mysteries are not things that we are trying to speak to God to inform Him about something He doesn't know. No, God knows everything. These mysteries that we are speaking by the Spirit are not for God's benefit. They are for our benefit. So as we pray in the Spirit, we are speaking forth the mysteries which our mind has no knowledge about, but it is the knowledge which the Holy Spirit wants to impart to us. Now, of course, when we pray in the Spirit, we could pray, the Holy Spirit could give us knowledge about situations and things and people that need to be prayed for, definitely. But also, when we pray in the Spirit, the Holy Spirit can give us knowledge and understanding of things concerning our own lives and concerning the decisions that we need to make. So when you are praying in tongues, when you are praying in the Spirit, you are praying mysteries, you are praying knowledge given to you by the Holy Spirit, which is for your benefit. And as you pray that out, your spirit is going to begin to understand that knowledge. Your spirit is going to receive revelation, and you are going to begin to understand, this is the course of action God wants me to take. This is the future God has assigned for me. These are the things God has prepared for me. Therefore, I need to make this decision so that I can walk into that future. Some of these things may be beyond what your mind knows about, and that's what mysteries are. Your mind may not even be prepared for it, but as it comes out of your spirit, you'll begin to recognize that this is knowledge given to you by the Holy Spirit, and you will begin to move into the very things which God has prepared for you, what eyes haven't seen, what ears haven't heard, what has not entered into the heart of man. So pray in the Spirit as you seek God's wisdom and guidance to make decisions for your life. Let's pray. Lord, we ask that you will help us pray in the Spirit. And I pray for those listening, God, if there are people who are not yet praying in tongues, who are not yet praying in the Spirit, I pray and I ask for them that you will baptize them with your Holy Spirit, and they will have the ability to pray in heavenly languages coming forth out of them, that they will speak in tongues, that will pray in the Spirit, receive knowledge, receive mysteries, as the Holy Spirit gives them, so that they will know the things you have planned and prepared for their lives. I pray this for them in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.